It's Madden NFL 24, and if it's in the game, it's in the game. It's the Cards and the Texans. All that and more, coming up next.
It's the National Football League, presented by EA Sports. Straight ahead, we've got a pretty good one on tap here, as it'll be the Arizona Cardinals taking on the Houston Texans. Brandon Gaudin joined, as always, by Charles Davis. CD, it's been a tough few years here in Houston. 4-4-3. Those are their win totals the last three seasons. But in as D'Amico Ryans as head coach, what do you think he brings to the table?
And it's interesting you brought up the number three, because D'Amico Ryans is the third head coach in three seasons for this team. What he brings to the table: toughness, organization, and hope. He wanted to be the head coach of the Houston Texans, the team he played for.
And for the visiting Cardinals, you know, this is a team in flux a little bit. J.J. Watt retired. There's a new coaching staff in place. They've got some work to do to turn around what was a 4-13 campaign in 2022.
I remember this franchise won 11 games in 2021, but everything's new now. Head coach, the way they're going to run things on offense, style of play on defense, but sometimes that change can be really good.
And we are underway from NRG Stadium in Houston. This fielded right at the goal line. And he takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, call it the 26. So here are the Texans now with a fresh face at quarterback, the second overall pick from Ohio State, C.J. Stroud.
For every rookie prospect, there are always nerves involved in this moment, running your team out to start a game. But there's a reason they brought him in. We're willing to make him their starter today. They believe he can overcome those nerves and lead his team to a victory. We saw him do it at the collegiate level and really make himself into a leader and someone you can envision doing the exact same thing here in the NFL.
Stroud sets up the play action. That'll be pulled in downfield by Collins. Still going inside the 20. Touchdown, Houston. Nico Collins, 74 yards. And the Texans get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. Walking into the stadium, we saw a ton of people donning the jerseys of this rookie quarterback, so you know they love that opening drive, and he throws a touchdown pass.
He gave a little bit of confirmation about what they had hoped, right? Because they thought they had a quarterback. They're thinking they have a quarterback. You do this, they believe they've got a quarterback. Look up, elbowing each other up in the stands. That's our guy.
Extra point right down the middle, and that makes the score 7-0. Well, the offense wasn't out there for a long time, but they were out there for a good time. One play, and they're able to hit pay dirt. The Texans kick team as they'll send this one away. And Greg Dortch now to return it. This taken in right around the goal line. And he won't quite make it to the 25. The Cardinals offense set to take over for the first time, and they are piloted by their fifth-year quarterback, two-time Pro Bowler as well, Kyler Murray.
And the tendency for most of these guys is to want to match things right away, because they have a lot of confidence in their talent too. They just saw a big strike against their team, and you know they're thinking to themselves, I can get this back right now on one play. Well, if it's there, you take it, but otherwise, just go ahead and calm your team down. Run the offense, get things going, and see how things settle in.
First down, Murray. Slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down.
And that's an early scramble that can be viewed positively by either side. From the offensive point of view,
it begins to establish him as a possibility to keep it on certain plays. And defensively, they avoided giving up a huge play in one of their first tests in containing a quarterback on the run.
The throw over the middle, taken in. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 22 yards there, a first down. Now the veteran workhorse, here's James Conner, taken down at the 47-yard line. The time called here because a member of the Texans is in some discomfort. Hopefully, obviously nothing serious here. Medical staff, though, going to take a peek, and we'll take a break. Second down and 8. They'll stay on the ground with Conner again, and they get him behind the line, so that short gain on first down quickly negated. They'll wind up losing 3, and now it's third down.
That's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that, got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
Screen pass to Conner. And he can only manage to get this to the 45-yard line, well short of the first. 5 yards, not enough, and it'll be fourth down.
Boy, that one was well read defensively, and this is all about diagnosis as a safety and being decisive, because he saw it setting up in front of him, able to knife through there and make the play.
And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. This one angles out of bounds in a good spot in the coffin corner. And they're going to mark this out of the 5-yard line.
That's a double win there, partner. You keep out of the return man's hands, and you pin him inside the 5-yard line. Pretty darn good.
A man coming off a great rookie year, it's Damian Pierce. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play there, second down. He can rack up those tackles in bunches in the run game from that middle linebacker spot.
And what he has to do is make sure he congratulates the guys in front and tells them thanks a lot, because as the guy in the middle, the Mike linebacker, you're counting on your front 3, your front 4, if you're up 5, whatever you've got in front of you, to take up all the blocking, allow you to roam and hit, and that's what he did on that play.
They were looking for a little spark and some breathing room. They got it right there, a gain of 14 and a first down.
I know a lot of times we like to put players in certain boxes. He does this and he does that. But this guy, he can do a little bit of everything. He's not just a lead blocker or a guy who protects the passer. Handing the ball, he might want to get out of the way.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
Now a 2nd and 10. Pierce takes it straight ahead. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6.
Playing against a 3-4 front is really challenging for offensive linemen because they can do so many different things. But when you're running the football, if you can handle the nose tackle up front, and it may be a guard can slide up to the second level and block a linebacker, that's when you have success running the football.
They run with the former Buffalo Bill, Devin Singletary. And this will be a Texans first down as he's got this past the 35 to about the 37.
Not too shabby for his first carry of the game. That's exactly what most teams are looking for, a really good change of pace back.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. Pierce now up the middle. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
Now that's a big time run. Lightning in a bottle, forget it. He exploded out of the bottle for that type of a pickup.
So into Cardinal territory now. It's first and 10 at the 43. They go again with Pierce. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. Zaven Collins there to make the play defensively.
That felt like a trap because it looked to me like the opposing front was on that play from the get-go. They had everyone crashing the ball carrier before he even made the line, and they hold him to just a yard.
From the 42-yard line, here's the second down and 9. Stroud looking to throw. A short one going to be taken in here by Schultz. And that's good for a gain of 6, and that'll bring us to a 3rd and 4.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
He had the touchdown earlier. This one's going to get him a first down.
Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass in the first drive and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw when they went through 2-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations. Ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one. I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. He wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Play action. Here's Stroud. And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's 3rd down.
Play action is supposed to be used to slow down pressure, slow down blitzes. In this case, though, if it takes a little too long to develop, you got people right in your face.
And lucky just to get rid of the ball with the arm going forward. Could have been a fumble. Stroud on 3rd down now. To Pierce, they set up the screen. And he will not make it to that imaginary yellow line as they get him to the ground at about the 23. 5 yards on the screen, but that'll take us to 4th down.
Boy, that was certainly well read defensively. And the key to any screenplay is space to work, and there was none to be found there, and they tackle it for just a short gain.
And this one is right through, and that will extend their lead even further. So a touchdown on their opening drive, and 3 more here, and it adds to their first quarter lead.
Yeah, everything's going according to plan so far because the offense has moved the ball, defense able to do their job, and here the special teams unit comes through with their contribution. A field goal to make it 10-0.
So after the made field goal, 10-0 here early as the kick's away. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. So the Cardinals offense back onto the field here for their 2nd drive of the game. They'll look to get something started. They need to, down 10-0 early as they've got it 1st and 10. They start the drive with Connor. And he'll push his way forward to about the 32. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down. When you're down early, how do you get back in the game, maybe establish the run? I think they're trying to do that.
Now, I'm with you on that one, and what I like about the message is that there's no panic from the head coach. He's already told his offensive coordinator, let's run the football, let's get things settled down a little bit and find our way back into this game.
And the defense closes quickly there, and he'll get maybe a yard to the 33.
Brandon, we talk all the time about those hybrid players, guys who can do more than one thing. And I think if you're playing strong safety in the NFL today, you are a true hybrid. Part linebacker, part cover guy.
And coming up, sticking his nose in the mess there and making a nice play defensively. Murray gonna throw. He'll get that one complete to Connor. That is brought down short. 2 yards there, needed four.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing, and they shut that one down with little gain.
Blake Gillikin on to punt now on fourth down. Fair catch called for and made at the 16 or maybe the 17-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Texans will take over. Stroud now on first and 10. Over the middle, he gets it to Collins. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first. How about the first quarter he's putting together out wide? Pretty impressive.
I think that he likes the fact that we're playing this as a day game. You know, some guys, they respond better in the evenings. For some reason, it builds up. For this guy, day game, and he is off and running. You're exactly right. 100 might be conservative with the start that he's had here in the first quarter.
Yeah, by the numbers, he's on pace for 200-plus right now. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch, and it'll be second down. If you're these receivers, you got to be ready, because when he's going to throw it quick on that RPO, he's going to throw it quick.
And this is why you spend time with your guy either in the offseason, during the week, the whole bundle. Because sometimes it's just telepathy. You both see the same thing, and he knows, get the ball to him right away.
That's caught again by Schultz. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. If they've got good hands, then, of course, they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play, and that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
The throwing again is Stroud. Over the middle here to Brown. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two. Second and a couple. And they'll send the slot in motion left. On second down, here's Pierce. And he'll get it across midfield and down into Cardinal territory. It'll be a gain of two on the play, but they'll remain a few inches short here with third down looming. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
Pierce will try to pick it up, and he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. 10-0 to score after one on EA Sports. Ready for the second quarter from Houston. It's the Texans in possession of the football as they've got it with a first and 10. A give up the middle to Singletary. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
From the 35, here's second and a yard. Now to change things up, Stroud will throw it. That's to the veteran. It's Robert Woods. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Cardinals' 24-yard line. 11 more yards there, and this methodical drive continues. And they'll throw it with Stroud here, first and 10. That's complete to Pierce. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. 11 yards there, just like last play. And now some disagreement down on that sideline. The red flag is out, and we're going to get a challenge. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, it certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Well, here's the call.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So the challenge there does not go their way. This will indeed remain a completed pass. From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. Back to the ground with Pierce. And here he'll get it down to the 7. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
From the 7, it's second and 5. On the bootleg, Stroud. His pass caught at the 4. And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out of bounds. So the completion good for just 3. And it makes it 3rd down and 2 yards to go. Now Stroud. He had a man open, but he missed him, and it's incomplete.
And based on my math, they've only converted 1 time thus far in this game, so you can see the frustration starting to come out a little bit. 3rd downs, they've been a problem for them all game. They've got to start becoming solutions.
The offense staying out. They're going to go on 4th and 2. They'll try and run for it. Texans' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. Extra point forthcoming. He's got it, and it's 17-0. So that one, a 13-play drive in total. And it was Damian Pierce closing things out with a touchdown run. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And we don't want to call this desperation time, especially in the second quarter, but you're down.
You don't want to.
No, but hold on, let me finish.
Okay, my bad.
You're down 3 scores already. You've done nothing offensively, nothing on the scoreboard. That's not a good combination.
I think you just called it. I think you just called it desperation time. I think you did. But let's face it, you mentioned this to me in a break earlier in the game. The energy level hasn't been there right from the start. We've noticed that. They've got to find a way to get on their toes and start punching instead of retreating to use a boxing net.
There he goes, left side. And they've got it well across midfield down to the 40 before it's all said and done. A big run there, 29 yards and a first. Thought they were going to have him down a lot earlier, but he was able to shed that tackle.
Shows the value of the weight room, doesn't it? Shows the value of the attitude when you run the football. Don't go down easily. Break a few tackles, gain some additional yardage.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Now Murray. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
This is certainly a team that has proven it likes to target its backs through the air, and defensively, they were aware of that and certainly were prepared on that throw.
Here's second and 10. Throwing now is Murray. Over the middle and into the hands of his receiver, Moore. They get 7 out of that, so they're left with a 3rd and 3.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver, that makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
Eluding the pressure right. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. Give him 7 on the tuck and run, and it'll get him a new set of downs.
Certainly not a positive sign if you're the D coordinator and you see your guys give up that space so early in the game. Third down, that's when the clamps are supposed to come out, but his ability to create things with his legs makes things difficult.
Murray now on first down. He's going to go down here. A sack. They push him back to the 34. That was Will Anderson getting home and finishing the play.
3 scores down, not even a halftime yet. They are not getting much generated offensively. They've got to figure it out.
It's tough because this defense just seems to be playing with so much confidence right now.
They really are. They are on their toes, and they're getting at them.
So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. From the gun, Murray. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. The pressure really ratcheting up. They get the sack on first down, then a near sack. They got to him there just as it was leaving his hand.
Yeah, they might need to change their pass protection scheme a little bit. Maybe bring another guy into the backfield to help protect the quarterback, because that was awfully close.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
This defense has certainly played well so far in this game, and the coverage has been tight on just about every throw. Forced a few here so far in this game, and now it brings up fourth down.
Fourth down, Murray off, and the Cards field goal unit and Matt Prater out there now. On the left hash, officially it's called a 51-yard attempt. And the 39-year-old veteran puts it right through. And they're on the board at least here. It's now 17-3.
So, Charles, they are on the board after that kick. So, 3 drives, 3 points. Obviously not the start that you were hoping for, but they're able to erase that 0 off the scoreboard.
Yeah, I guess what you're saying is a point a drive is not what offenses are striving for by any stretch. They're happy they've got 3 now. They hope that that unlocks their offense for bigger points down the road.
Prater now will send it away following the made field goal. Desmond King to return it from his end zone. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Offense back out there along with Damian Pierce. He's over 40 yards here in the second quarter. Been nice and effective for them, hasn't he?
He has definitely been dependable, and really shouldn't underestimate what he's getting done here, because anytime you're on a pace that's going to approach 100 yards, you've really done some damage in an NFL game.
And now he's looking just to add to his totals. Stroud to the air on first and 10. And that's going to be incomplete.
And I can see the officials kind of looking at each other down there, silently wondering, does this meet the level of grounding? Fortunately, he did have a receiver in the area, but I have seen less obvious throwaways called as penalties.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Give to Pierce. And room to run as he's up past the 35-yard line.
55 yards rushing for him now in the ball game.
Well, this play sequence was really kind of called in reverse. Incomplete pass on first and 10. Nice run on second and 10 when probably everyone was expecting him to throw the football. Now, if you're the defense, what are they going to do on third down? You're a little off balance.
Now here's Stroud on third down.
Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 10 yards there. Good enough for a Texan first down.
Well, things are definitely going right for them here in the first half. Pick it down, any down, even third down, no problem. They get a connection there and pick up a fresh set of downs, continuing to move the ball.
First and 10, it's Pierce.
And no room that time, getting it to about the 46. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Whenever we talk about the best strong safeties, one word constantly comes up, and that's instincts. Being able to diagnose run or pass and make the appropriate moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that running play. And Pierce gets it again on second down.
And he'll get it across midfield and down to the Cardinal territory. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4.
I think we all suspected that they were going back to him after he found the end zone on his last carry. And they kept the positive momentum going there. Another nice run by him.
This offense so far on third down, they've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This is 3rd and 4. They'll run a draw now with Singletary.
And he won't get to the marker. He's a yard short. A pickup of 3. It leaves him with 4th and 1.
But a good play is made on defense. Oftentimes, leverage is the key to everything. Defensive line not getting turned. All the other guys making sure they're in the right spot. And on that play, they were able to stop him short of a first down.
Now on 4th down, it's Cameron Johnston on to punt it away. Greg George deep for Arizona.
Out of bounds as he appeared to be looking for the corner. He got it. They're going to mark this at the 4-yard line.
The football back in the hands of the Arizona Cardinals. And it's been very much a slow start for them. 3 drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is 1. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
They start with a give to Connor. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks.
I'm okay with the call there. In fact, I actually like it. I know they're down a couple of scores, but the running game worked in that situation. I would continue to go in that direction.
Now they can breathe a little easier, some room to operate, as they've got it 1st and 10 now out past the 20. They stay on the ground. Here's Connor again. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
A short one here, caught by McBride.
So they'll get nothing out of that play, and that'll leave them with a 3rd and 2.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there are more people there to get him down.
They'll try and run for it with Connor.
And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. 3rd and 2 is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
Right back to Connor here on first. They'll get it across the 35. It'll be 2nd down.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
Second and 7. Murray again. This is Connor. And they get him behind the line. So that short gain on first down, quickly negated. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play. So now third down coming up.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football. But that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result. Negative yardage. And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action. Now play number 7 of this drive, but it's a tough 3rd and 9. Murray now. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Now the Texans will burn the first of their timeouts. So as they talk it over, we step aside. Blake Gillikin on to punt here as he'll send this one away. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Fair catch called for and made right at the 25-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Texans will take over with a 1st and 10. Damian Pierce taking the field with the rest of the Texans offense. He's been good. His guys are winning. So far, the recipe working here in the second quarter.
And he doesn't like to just tote the rock. He wants to carry his team on his back. And that's what he's done throughout this game.
Yeah, he's done that. He'll be hoping to continue that trend. On 1st down, here's Stroud. He's got his man. It's Pierce. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
Here's Stroud. Out route, and it's complete to Brown. A gain of 5, good enough for the 1st down. Stroud. Going to Woods, but that pass is intercepted. Picked off by Chris Barnes. And it's a terrific return here as he's going to have him set up with a 1st and goal right at about the 6-yard line. That time defensively looked like they showed quite a bit of pressure, but backed off, and it proved fruitful. They get the pick.
He went through all of his rules about getting rid of the ball quickly because he read blitz. He saw all those people stacked at the line of scrimmage, and then they fooled him by dropping into coverage. Now he's ready to get rid of the ball fast, but guess what? Too many defenders out there. Exactly as you described, an interception.
This is 1st and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. After the turnover, here's Murray. Screen pass to Connor. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. He'll get only 2 there, and it's 2nd and goal.
Nice job by the defense figuring that play out and holding it to a short game, but I don't think the offense is going to be daunted. They actually accomplished their goal there. Now they've got them aware that they can throw a screen at them, maybe to slow the pass rush down a little bit, and they can throw it downfield.
Out of the gun, here's Murray. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is 3rd and goal. Here's Murray. He's got his man. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Rondale Moore. As the first half is winding down, and the Cardinals are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the 1st half. Until that late score here in the second quarter, they'd only had the field goal, so that's just big to see that football get into the end zone.
Yeah, and when you look at the scoreboard now, nothing seems out of reach. They've been outplayed in the first half, but when the clock hits zeros as they head into the half, you know what I do as a head coach?
What?
I tell my team to sprint to the locker room to show that we've got the momentum and show that we're right back in this game.
Prater for the extra point, and that slices the lead down to 17-10. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line. Houston's offense already at the line, set to get going. And with only 9 seconds remaining, and not much time, we'll see how they play this. They'll indeed start on the ground to run that clock. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report.
All right, BG, thanks very much, and welcome one and all to our beautiful new downtown Orlando studios for this EA Sports Halftime Report. We saw Damian Pierce put together a strong performance in that first half. He had a touchdown run that helped get his guys this halftime lead.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number three. One touchdown is the difference. 17-10 our score, and we are back underway on EA Sports. Greg Dortch returning. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. The Cardinals ready to go here to start the third quarter. Well, out of the locker rooms, here they come. Their first drive of the third quarter. And Charles, they're trailing in this ball game, but we got a tight one and set up to be a very entertaining second half.
And as we know, partner, in the NFL, there's trailing and there's trailing, right? Sometimes you're discouraged by how much you're down, but in this case, this is a tight ball game, so there's a sense of optimism here. I think they went in at the half and looked at their play sheet and said, these are the plays we really like. What do you say we use them to start the second half and get us going?
First down, Murray. Now a quick throw there, but it's going to be incomplete. Marquise Brown was the intended target, but it'll be second down. Murray now to throw. A short one here, caught by McBride. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down for a nice little gain. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short, so it'll be third and less than a yard.
The coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there, and how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many.
Oh, he tried to fit it in on the slant, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Denzel Perryman, and they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. Tough one there. First drive of the third quarter, throw an interception, and now a chance that they could be an even a bigger hole if they can convert this into points.
Yeah, but how good do you feel if you're that defensive coordinator right now? Because you just know that the head coach looked at him and said, turn him loose, big man, and he'd be able to take a few extra chances playing with this type of a lead, and boy, it paid off.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. As Stroud now to throw. On a slant, here's Collins. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. They get 14 on that one. Good for a Houston first down.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
They'll run on first down with Singletary. And some determined running there as he'll pick his way down to the 12-yard line. That's good for a Texan first down, a 12-yard pickup. Good push up front in that run in between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they're able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to roam.
First and 10, it's Stroud. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Running it out of the gun with Pierce. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and 7 ahead.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Stroud on third down now. He had him. He was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete.
That's going to hurt a bit because they needed to come through with a completion there. Now a drive that started with great field position is facing fourth down.
Plenty of shouts from this crowd as they watch the replay. They want a challenge, and they're going to get one. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How is the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
Now they'll line up to kick the extra point. And the lead is up to 14. The drive summary that time, 5 plays. And the result, a Houston touchdown. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. So now, Charles, this drive, maybe a touch more important, trying to erase the memory of that interception they had the last time out.
Yeah, and everyone goes through this because even the best in the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you and interceptions result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call, but how you carry yourself, how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
Oh, man, that wasn't far from breaking in a big way into the secondary. Read option, quarterback kept it, and while he didn't get a first down, he did get a nice chunk of yardage. Only a nice tackle prevented it from maybe going all the way.
On second down, here's Murray. Throwing quickly to Wilson. With a quick slant, good for 8 and a first.
This is the call for the score.
out of the shotgun, they'll run with Connor to the 43, second down.
Well, from an offensive perspective, that was a tough run because he only picked up 3 yards. But let's flip it over to the defensive side. They now have the advantage. 3 3-yard gains, that means they're punting the ball likely on fourth down. That's what you're looking for when you're playing defense.
Moore, the man in motion. Connor going to get it again on second down. And this one not going anywhere. They get him at the 44 for a gain of just a yard.
Oftentimes we praise an offense for their variety, being able to hit people with a run in the pass. But in this game, how about what we're seeing from the safeties? They are all over the field. Doesn't matter if they threw it or if they're trying to run it.
I don't think we've ever awarded an MVU, most valuable unit, but you're right. It might go to them in this game.
I like that, MVU. Well done.
He'll get that one complete to Connor. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. They'll get only a yard out of that, and it'll bring up fourth down.
The key to any screen play is all in the deception. That means everyone on the offensive side of the ball. But someone gave it up because that one wasn't very well concealed. And the defense able to rally to him and hold him for just a short game.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. And well done here. That one will kick out of bounds at about the 8-yard line. Here's Nico Collins, and this offense getting set to go for another drive.
Good day for him so far here in the third quarter. He's hit pay dirt once, over 100 yards, but hey, it's the third quarter. He's thinking, I want more, right?
He wants more, and it just increases the confidence of his team because every play he makes, that means his quarterback is really feeling good about throwing the football. Probably feels like he can't throw an incomplete pass when he throws it to him right now.
Yeah, he's looked really, really sharp.
They'll start on the ground with Pierce. And a short pickup here as he'll get across the 10 to the 11-yard line. Tackle made there by Buda Baker.
It may be only a gain of 3 yards, but that back, he deserves a lot more credit on the play. That could have easily been stopped at the line, but his vision and his determination found some space to turn it into that modest gain.
Stroud to throw it. Schultz hauls in the quick throw. And he'll get this to the 22. So they began the play at the 11, and it's a gain of 11. First down.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a 2-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. 11 more on that one, and another first down.
That's another beautiful throw right there. Gets it to his man right in stride, and I think that throw kind of exemplifies what we've seen from this offense throughout this game. They've been in rhythm, they've been sharp, they've been on it, and they pick up another first down there.
A short one going to be taken in here by Schultz. He's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
It certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle, you put it all together, you got a heck of a tight end candidate.
78 yards rushing for him now as he's carried it 16 times.
Any team that runs the toss and runs it successfully, that means they win the battle on the edges. That means you seal the edge in order to let your back get to the corner. They got it done there for a very nice game.
First down, they go right back to Pierce. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Well, partner, I guess sometimes it's just a matter of philosophy. Some say run until they absolutely stop you, and others say, well, when you think they're about to stop you, fool them a little bit. I guess they should have tried to fool them on that play.
So the first down run lost a couple. Now they come up second and 12.
Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete. Woods will say he should have had it, and it's third down. We'll see what they have drawn up here. A little bit behind the line. 12 yards needed to gain a first down. From the gun on third down, here's Stroud.
Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. They'll get only a yard out of that, and it'll bring up fourth down.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back. But how about the way they ran to the football and knocked him down to force a fourth down?
Here's Cameron Johnston now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. This is away, but boy, headed straight for the sidelines. And this punt will go out of bounds. I think it'll be inside the 25, and it will. Right at the 24-yard line is where they'll spot it.
Arizona's offense back out and ready to go. Defense got the better of them last series, forcing a punt. See if they make a few changes in the game plan here and try to get points out of this drive. First and 10. Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their own 24. They'll start the drive with a give to Connor. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
That's pretty much meat and potatoes right there, wasn't it? Just go right at him and let your big horse charge up the middle. Not too fancy there, was it?
Nothing fancy at all. Challenging that defense, and on that go-around, the offense won the challenge. Throwing on first down is Murray. And this is caught. It's Brown. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Give him 16 yards there, and it's a Cardinals first down as well.
A couple of first downs right in succession, and this is an offense that could really use a good drive, and they're off to a fast start here.
So a first and 10 now in Houston territory at the 49-yard line. They run behind center with Connor, and a 6-yard gain gets them right around the 43.
They've created a nice sustained drive off of plays like that. A nice strong run there that keeps them advancing the ball.
Line of scrimmage, the 43 on second and 4.
Here's Murray as he sets to throw it.
Throwing quickly there, but it's incomplete.
He's a little trigger happy right there, and it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
They'll fake it to Connor. Now Murray. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete.
And he's going to be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans' 27-yard line. They give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
And that's well executed there on third down, and I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
Down to the 25.
Brought down on the play by the linebacker, Christian Harris.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
Now second and 9.
They'll stay on the ground with Connor again. And he's going to be close to a first down as the tackle is made at the Texans 17.
94 yards rushing for him now to this point.
Look, all the guys with the ball are having a whole lot of fun keeping it on the ground. The guys on the opposite side, they are having zero fun. They've been getting pushed around the entire game and haven't found an answer yet to slow down the running game.
Murray to throw on third and 1. God, they would have gotten the conversion if he could hold on. Instead, the drop means it'll be fourth down. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously, one that should have been caught. They got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
Oh, Connor loses it. And one of the linebackers has got it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And hindsight 2020, I think they probably should have gone for the field goal, right?
The 3 points would look really good right now, but I think what we just saw there, analytics really starting to creep into the game, because more and more teams are saying the more you go for it, the better your odds of getting it, the better your odds of scoring 6 points instead of three. They took a chance there. It just didn't pay off.
Yeah, right here, the anti-analytics guys go thumbs up. And now before the ball changes hands, they're going to take a look at this just to make sure that they have it right. Now the question, was the knee in fact down before this ball comes loose? And is the video convincing enough to overturn it?
A lot of factors here. Remember, you also need clear possession of the football afterwards. This is a tough one to overturn.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. So this drive going to continue following the conversion on fourth. Here's first and 10. Connor up the middle. And he'll be taken down after a decent gain, and that will bring us to the end of this third quarter of play. We have played three quarters. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Back now in Houston. It's Cardinal football, but they trail here as we get set to bring you the fourth and final quarter. Second down, ball on the three. First down marker at the 1 yard line. From the gun, a give to Connor. And he's maybe going to get this back to the four, but that's about all. Call it no gain that time, as it's going to leave him with a third and about three to go. He's having a big game running the football, but that will hurt the yards per carry a little bit.
Yeah, but the average he's got so far, that's the type of average he wants to take with him to contract negotiations, doesn't he?
Murray going to try to throw on third down. And that is caught by Brown for a Cardinal touchdown. 4 yards on the touchdown grab. And the Cardinals have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. An out route there for the score, a quick out route there for the score.
Yeah, you're not really surveying the defense on this one. You're just counting on timing, making this play happen. 1-2, ball's out of his hands, knows where he's going, just puts it to the outside. Touchdown.
Extra point good by Prater. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. King going to look to bring it out. And good coverage there on special teams as he'll get him down shy of the 20. Houston's offense taking over again. Their lead back down to one score after the touchdown a moment ago. First down's a must on this drive as they start out here first and 10. Ground, it's Pierce to begin the drive. A good gain of 9 before he's brought down at the 28. If you can keep getting gains like that, Charles, with the lead here in the fourth quarter, I mean, keep running it, right?
No doubt about it, but what the offense coordinator has to do is understand they're going to continue to stack the line of scrimmage. What runs do you have in your arsenal that'll work against a stacked box and continue to move the ball?
And they'll go play action here with Stroud. And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it. Now
The Texans on third down. They're at 50%, 4 for 8. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. Pierce will try to pick it up. And he's going to get to the 31, enough for the first down. A third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough.
I like that run right there, partner. Not the flashiest run, not the one that's going to break for big yardage, but he understands the situation. And taking care of the football, paramount, and he got it done.
Nursing that slim lead, you're exactly right. Hold on to that ball. First and 10, it's Pierce. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
The old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach? He's in big trouble.
They're still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
On third down, here's Pierce. Shoves him aside. And shedding the tackle, and that's room. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. 121 yards rushing for him now as his sensational afternoon continues. And carries like that, that's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
So into Cardinal territory now. It's 1st and 10 at the 36. Here's Pierce on the counter. And tough sledding. He'll get maybe a yard. Stop short of the 35.
I'm sure that that's going to be the formula. Just keep the ball on the ground. Keep that clock moving.
And when you have the lead this late in the game, above all, stay in bounds. Yes, take care of the football. Yes, gain yardage, but stay in bounds and let that clock tick.
Stroud now on 2nd down. And oh, he's unable to hold on to that defensively. A potential game changer, but it falls incomplete.
I think he's taking an awful chance with the football right there. You've got a lead, you've got to protect it, and he's taking chances putting it out there in a little bit of jeopardy.
Especially in a spot like this, fourth quarter, as you said, trying to cling to that advantage.
Yeah, that one probably should have been picked, huh?
And now the 3rd down throw incomplete as well.
Nice call by the defense there on 3rd down. Just flood the field with extra defensive backs in their dime package. Nowhere to go with the football. Forces the incompletion.
So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. This to make it a 2-score game. And his kick is good. And that will extend their lead even further. So that's, CD, an important one here in the fourth quarter.
And that importance cannot be overstated. All eyes on both sidelines were staring that one down all the way. The significance is that they made it a 2-score game. Still lots of time left to go, but likely that was their goal at the start of the drive. Get 3 points, make it a 2-score game, and they were able to get it done.
Out is the Texans kick team as they'll send this one away. And he'll go down as this drive will start at the 25-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And the complexion of this one has changed a fair amount. That last field goal made it a 2-score game, so they need to get points out of this drive relatively quickly. Murray and the Cardinals with a 1st and 10 at their 25-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Will Anderson picks up his 2nd sack of the afternoon.
He was really focused downfield, but there was really no viable options. The coverage was too good.
And the defense really quickened the tempo of that play with their pass rush because there was nowhere for him to go with the football. The only place he ended up, down on the ground.
Throwing on second and long. Murray. And he's got the hook up to Moore. They'll wind up getting just a yard. And they're going to be staring at a third and long here.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
How to approach this. Third down and 16 yards to go.
They take a shot downfield there, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Going for the knockout blow right there. I think if I'm up two scores, I'd be worried about an interception, but playing this way is what got them this lead. So you may as well ride it out to the end.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Now Murray's got to have this one. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Cardinals unable to convert there on fourth down. And boy, possession here turns over with the football already being in the red zone. So they really needed points here in a two-score game. Could not come away with anything there on fourth.
And while we know they're a little bit discouraged here, they can't check out of this game. You and I have called a good number of games over the course of our career where we've seen these types of situations. Teams get the ball back, and that miracle does occur. So they can't let that dream go just yet. They have to get stout on defense here.
Yeah, right now really hoping for a turnover. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Back to throw. Here's Stroud. Well, that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down.
Once you get into the red zone, space is at a premium for receivers to try and operate and shake themselves free. That one's incomplete.
Second and 10. Now Stroud.
Well, so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure or do they play coverage on this down?
The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long.
Throwing now is Stroud.
And this is going to be incomplete.
The frustration evident there because he couldn't find anyone on third down, and he left no doubt that he was throwing that one away.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. From the left hash, it's a 36-yard attempt. And his kick is good. And that will extend their lead even further.
So the starting field position was terrific following the surprising turnover on downs, but the end result, only 3 points.
Simply stated, I think you have to look at that as a missed opportunity.
Is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. And last time, went for it on fourth, didn't get it. We'll see if they can pick themselves up off the mat and do better this go around.
Sometimes I have this vision of coaches writing notes to themselves before a game, and sometimes that note says, be aggressive, stay aggressive. Maybe that's what we saw in the last possession.
Yeah, they were very aggressive. This time, will it result in points? We'll find out. And able to steer clear of that first tackler as he works his way forward for about four.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls or setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later, and let's face it, you could do worse than a four-yard run on first down.
Second down, Murray sets to throw. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up third down.
Normally you think the tight end's gonna be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well, incomplete.
Here's Murray. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. That's a third down conversion of 24 yards there. Nice play.
All right, this is the time of the game where they're down a couple scores, and they've really got to get some yards in chunks, and they know the defense doesn't want to give those up, but they've got to find a way to take them anyway.
Now the question is, can they string a few of those together? So a first and 10 now in Houston territory at the 49-yard line. To throw is Murray. Pass to the right, and he's got McBride. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll leave him with a second and just a few inches left. Now that tight end position, it just seems to continue to evolve every year in the NFL.
Yeah, you're getting really terrific athletes. A lot of them maybe were wide receivers at one point that continue to give you speed, great hands, and big bodies, which make them excellent targets for quarterbacks.
And he's going to be taken down with another first down as the stop's made at the Texans' 29-yard line. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs. Again, they'll throw with Murray. And that is going to be incomplete as he let him a bit too much. He shook his head right when he released that throw. He knew it was going to be a little off target.
Yeah, the excitement got him on that one. Wasn't able to control the fact the receiver was open, and it would have been an easy throw.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. A quick throw here out to Brown. That'll leave him with a third and 2 coming up. They got 8 yards there. Throwing now is Murray. That is caught, and he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. Give him 6 yards, and they do convert on third.
But correct me if I'm wrong, you know, you're down 2 scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full 2-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call 2 plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
Over the middle, complete. It's Connor, and he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. That's good. The completion there for 7 yards, and it's second down. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Murray to air it out again. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Jonathan Greenard running in to pick up the sack.
Remember, throughout my career here in defensive coaches, I always say, guys, you got to earn the right to rush the passer. And they put themselves in a great spot with this big lead, and they know they've got to throw the ball.
These pass rushers have to be salivating. It is pin your ears back time indeed.
And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
Oh, man. Just when the D thought they had the answer for him, he went and changed the question. Surprises him by taking off himself. He's able to set up his offense pretty with a first and goal.
Murray now to throw.
Well, they certainly did a nice job there picking him up out of the backfield and then running stride for stride with it. That's good coverage, and it led to an incompletion.
Here now, second and goal. From the gun, Murray. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
All right, Captain. It's batting down the hatches time defensively. Dodged two pass attempts to the end zone. Now what do you think they're going to try and dial up on third and goal?
Well, knowing them and knowing what we've just seen, I think they're throwing it again, don't you?
I think you have to. I think in this situation, you've kind of run out of your running plays. Fire another one into the end zone.
Murray now, third and goal. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cardinals. Rondale Moore, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Cardinals have cut it back within a score.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively, though, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like,
yeah,
you know.
Doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. And now out comes Houston.
And with that last touchdown, I mean, we're set up for a good finish here. Some things to consider, Charles. Obviously, it's a very close game. You're in the fourth quarter. Defensively, they've got all three timeouts in their back pocket.
So the chess match really ramps up, doesn't it? Because in these situations, what do? Do you run the ball and kill the clock here? Or do you try and bury them with another score? And how about defensively? Do you use your timeouts as early as opportunity? Or wait till you hit the two-minute warning? So there's a lot going into this one. Let's see how each side goes about their strategy.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. Pierce takes it straight ahead. And not a whole lot there, maybe a yard in 27. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Texans football as we welcome you back. Now this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. And now right out of the two-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with a minute 56 to go. Here's Cameron Johnston now as he's on to punt for Houston. Fair catch called. It's taken in right at the 20-yard line. Kyler Murray now in the Cardinal offense. Down by 6. A minute 50 to play. They need a touchdown. A field goal is worthless now as they come up on 1st and 10. To throw is Murray. The throw here right sideline falls incomplete.
Work with me, partner. Take a deep breath, because that's what they're doing down the field now. That incompletion allowed them to exhale a little bit. Get in the huddle, kind of scan the crowd, see if any celebrities are here. Relax a little bit as they start this big drive.
They'll try again here. 2nd and 10. Back to throw, Murray. And that one's going to come up a little short. It's incomplete.
So back-to-back incompletions now, 3rd and 10. And first things first, before you think about marching the ball down the field, you got to move the chains.
You're exactly right. Got to get back into focus here. Get the first down. That's what's vital to them.
Well, this crowd is making an impact right now. Third and 10. Now Murray. And that's complete to Brown. And he is going to have a Cardinals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
That's a nice job right there, partner, because they were able to work down the middle of the field, working in the seams, because I think defensively, they were guarding the sidelines, trying to keep them from getting out of bounds. They took what they gave them, and it was successful.
Murray to throw. This is taken in by McBride. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
They'll look to throw, and he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second. As the clock stops here with 46 seconds left to play.
It has been a rough afternoon for him trying to get rid of the football. See, that's now 5 sacks.
How'd you like to be the offensive coordinator, the offensive line coach, trying to come up with an answer for this pass rush? What blocking assignments do you change? Can guys play a little bit better? And we're seeing the end result on the scoreboard. Long day in the pocket for their quarterback.
Now Murray. Back-to-back big plays defensively. First the sack. Now they force the incompletion on third and long. Things looking pretty good for them.
And this is where they have to be careful, because they've got the momentum going their way. They will be really amped up to get to the quarterback. Look out. Draw, screen, something that can be used against them.
This crowd turning up the decibel level. It's third and long. Back to throw. He's got Brown on the out route complete. They're making steady progress, but I see your face. You're worried about that clock.
I'm worried about the clock, and at some point, you have to have a splash play in there as well.
The decision made for them. They've got to go. It's fourth down. They're going for it. It's Murray. Working the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. The Cardinals forced to burn their third and final timeout, as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in the football game. Now this offense cannot stop the clock now. No timeouts remaining as they come up here first down.
Defensive back who can make a play on the football. So whether it's nickel, dime, quarter, whatever you want to call it, I want 5, 6, 7 guys back there.
Back to throw. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Saints back at the 31. It all came down to one final jump ball on the Hail Mary, but part of the defense was ready, able to force it to be incomplete. Ball game over.
Look, let's face it, everybody wants to work the ball in closer and take a more high percentage pass to try and tie the game. But the Hail Mary, that's what they had to work with. And now they're just hoping that their jumpers can get up higher and are stronger than the defenders. Not the case in this instance. They end up losing the game.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn. And this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. It's a win for the Texans as we say so long from Houston.